Mission the Light, August 12, 2018, letter number 35. The crowds of the earth wearing yellow cloaks. New revelations from Jesus to John the Apostle. I see the square of God with the holy temples again. They are located in the holy Jerusalem in heaven. As far as I can look, I see the endless sea of people. They are wearing light yellow cloaks. I feel it's necessary to have a different color so it can be distinct from the angels and the holy ones. The prophets are already in heaven and they are already wearing white cloaks. Almost all the residents of the earth here are wearing the yellow cloaks. All the newly ones who have brought here, all the ones who have suffered are also here, and all the ones who are ascending from the hand of Lord Jesus Christ. I see the angels washing all of us clean with the holy oil and the holy mirror. I see that as soon as we receive our heavenly blessings, the archangels dressing us in a pure white cloaks. My brothers and sisters, we, the people, look like a yellow sea. There was a large crowd, so large, was impossible to count them. I wished no one to be left behind. No, not one single soul. Here is so much beauty and serenity. All are in divine order and in peace. Every one of us have a smile on our faces. The angels love us, care and lead in us, teaching us how to stand to worship properly at the time of the ceremony. They are also combing our hair while the holy oil drips from our heads. With soft sponges, they put holy myrrh on our bodies. While the angels singing, they are dressing us in white cloaks. We are in the holy city, the one that mentioned in the holy scriptures. Finally, we live in the moment. When the light yellow sea of people becomes white, because we are cleansed beings now, then the angels instruct us to walk by the holy ones and to go into the seven temples. In the glory of the Father, the Son, Christ, and the Holy Spirit, there is so much faith and worship. The order is perfect. No one is pushing another to go first as we used to rush down on earth. It doesn't matter which color of the seven holy temples we enter. All the temples are holy. All of them is God's in undivided substance of essence. The color of the stones of each temple is so beautiful, and is for a healing for our souls in a supreme state. Either way, in eternity, we will be entering in them to worship in them. We will glorify with our deep faith, our prime creator, our father, our God. Everything in paradise will be ours, everything. Our Lord mentioned in the scriptures many times, even in Revelation chapter 21, verse 5, everything will be made new. They exist for us. We will live with God. Revelation 21, verse 1 through 4. All together we will make the body of God's church. As we know well, my brothers and sisters, the gathering in one place of faithful ones is called church. Only Christianity had a live body of our Lord. We are not fanatics to speak again and again about God. The knowledge is not fanatism. Simply, we introduce to everyone the great doctor, he who will heal us also. When we hear a fellow man complaining from illness that they have, and if we had suffered from the same thing, don't we introduce our doctors to them with love? So they can go too to get the proper healing as we have, receiving it, and when we receive it, and now we are healthy again. how much more we must introduce God. Perhaps many don't know Him properly, and some perhaps they don't know God at all. God calling every one of us. He uses many ways to make His presence known to us. He's showing us that He truly exists. He is beside us. But we must invite Him to walk in our hearts and in our lives. When the doorbell rings and we open the door, we see there a member of our family. With a great smile and joy, we tell this relative to come in. We welcome them, we hug them, and we kiss them. We smile to them, and we are joyful. We are going to leave them out there? Of course not. God is our Father. We show Him our love, our respect, and we welcome Him in our hearts and lives right away in there. We are let Him take the best seat in our living room, the best and the most comfortable chair in our heart. My friends, for our Father God, the heart was made. May the blindness we have to go away once and for all, the hypocrisy and the stubbornness may stripped away from us forever. May we never be like the Sadducees in Acts 4, verse 1 through 21. The Sadducees saw clearly the miracles performed by the apostles of God. They ignored it in the name of greed, and they turned their backs. They closed their eyes shut in ignorance. But they had a belief. How sad, Father God, to offer you the eternal gift of life and you turn your back to Him. No, a huge no, we must say. We must stop as soon as possible to try to hide the word of our Lord. We must stop at once to criticize the word of our benefactor. May we try to believe and trust Him. May we stop have refusal. May no one throw away this opportunity. May the light of our Lord be victorious when the Lord makes His appearance to us. Why say to Him, go, leave? Only benefit we have when we are stand beside Him. What we have to lose if we get to know Him better? Even if we don't know absolutely nothing, even if we have never read absolutely anything, not a single book about Him. May we ask Him to call us His children and to share to shape us in any shape He wants. Yes, may we are allowed ourselves to become clay and soft dough in His hands. The Lord will shape us in fatherly love and tenderness. I wish no one to lose the beauty of paradise because truly exists. Paradise is real, the kingdom is real, and they are ready waiting for our arrival. Amen.